Greetings, all you gallant gamers. Welcome back to another video. My name is Mango Crumble, and welcome to another Roundtable podcast. Today, we're going to be talking about the world record speedrun for Assassin's Creed 1 on console, any percent. Cowboy Bebop and a new series I'm watching, Game of Thrones. Yeah, which is pretty exciting. So, let's just jump right into it. Okay, so first of all, Assassin's Creed 1 speedrun, the world record for console. I think it was Xbox Series X. So basically, if you don't know who Lasers is, he part of the Four Pillars. He essentially won the world record for the fastest playthrough of Assassin's Creed 1. I think he streamed it like 3 times or something, and the first run I watched, I was like, oh my god, we can actually get the record, like, on the first run. That didn't happen, fortunately. There was like a glitch where basically with the there's like a thing where you get anonymous, and there's like a little symbol in the background, and yeah. And that was kind of broken, and he couldn't get off the bench. And the same thing happened. He went into a haystack, so it basically messed up his whole run. He did it a second time, but that run was messed up. And then he did it on... It was originally on Friday, but then, like, Friday last week. And then it was on the Sunday when he actually got the record. And yeah, that... Oh my god. I've never been so glued to a live stream ever in my life. That was so exciting. Oh my god. You could actually, if you actually look at the comments on there, I was going mental on the stream comments. So yeah. Oh, that was such a good win, and that was such a good thing for the community as well. So yeah. I hope, like, you know, there might be more something like competition in this, and people just like going trying to go get the record and getting back on the record, and, you know, it's just going to create some like fun competition on a really good game as well. Next, I'm going to talk about a series that I've actually previously watched quite a bit, but I'm rewatching kind of in order so I can get it make sense of it. So, Cowboy Bebop. Now, I started watching Cowboy Bebop like a few years. Actually, I think it's like a year ago or like 2 years ago. I first watched Cowboy Bebop, and I was watching the bit in order, kind of in order, and yeah. I started like watching it from the start again, which is I want to get it. You know, I want to understand it from like a what do you call it when you go forwards in time, a chronological way. So, what things I have to say about the show? It's got great music. I forgot the name of the person who did the music for it, but bloody hell, she's talented. And every episode, right? Every single episode has a different kind of theme and different song for each one. So there's like a blues episode one, and there's like a heavy metal one, and there's just every different genre for every different episode. So yeah, really, really good. And also the intro song, it's just so such a bop. You can probably hear it playing it right now. So yeah. Also, that bit with the harmonica kids, the kid with the harmonica, that was bloody weird, that little... He's so, like, weird and kind of slightly terrifying, and that... It just covers so much genre and so much emotion and so much kind of types of storytelling. It's like its own... It's almost like an experiment of how far you can go with an anime, and it really does. Yeah, and also the bit, that was a bit with the character which almost made me cry with one part, which Yeah, I think if you know the series, you know what I'm talking about. That's... Yeah. Favourite characters? I mean, the main guy is Spike Spiegel, and he's pretty cool. He does get quite annoyed when... He can quite get quite bickery when things aren't going to plan and stuff, but... When he's just he's just mostly cool most of the time, but yeah. There's a lot of kind of gunfighting and martial arts stuff as well, and also the bit, oh my god, the bit with Vicious on the fight at the bit where you kind of at the cathedral, and he was literally using like his gun to parry the sword, and he was literally fighting with literally like punching and then shooting and then deflecting and stuff. That's so cool. Yeah, just all the characters just are really good as well. Yeah, I can't really praise enough. It's a really good show. I've got to about the episode where they introduce Ed. Yeah. So, enough on Cowboy Bebop, and let's get on to Game of Thrones. Now, Game of Thrones, I've heard about the series for quite a while, you know, as everyone has, and most people do know about Game of Thrones and stuff, but I'm probably, like, the last person to watch it, and also the series kind of ended. I've heard that the actual show, like the last series itself, is a bit mediocre and it kind of goes a bit downhill on the like last two series, but from what I've been watching so far in the first series, it is, oh, it's so good. It's like, it's probably the closest I would think to a show like Avatar The Last Airbender, because that show had that sort of kind of fantasy universe and that kind of world building and those kind of characters and those that kind of jumping in between different characters with different plot lines going on at the same time and maybe like focusing on different characters per episode. I got about to episode 5 and yeah, I don't think the first episode was very good. It's kind of a bit overblown with the nudity and the sexual stuff, so yeah, it was kind of, I know it's trying to be like an kinda adult show, but I think it was kind of just doing it for the sake of it instead of actually doing it because, you know, it actually enhances it. My favorite character is probably Tyrion, the little dwarf bloke. Yeah, he's like, he's such a laugh, and as well he's very kind of wise and secure as well. I think his sort of friendship with Jon's kind of growing. It reminds me a lot of Iroh and Zuko in Avatar The Last Airbender. So he's kind of like a sort of mentor for him, and also because they're both kind of social kind of, not outcasts, but they're not exactly kind of what in the Game of Thrones universe is kind of accepted people, because Tyrion's a dwarf and also Jon Snow's a bastard son of Ned Stark, so I think he has to learn to embrace himself and accept himself, and yeah, I think that's part of the plot line with him. That's what I'm guessing. I think another favourite character is probably Eddard, who's played by Sean Bean. It's probably the reason why I wanted to watch the show, because, no, I like Sean Bean, he's a laugh, and yeah, and I think he's just such a strong character, but he's kind of always pushed around to follow. Has a sense of duty about him, that even if it's something morally kind of quite wrong, he still does it because that's what the law is. So he's very kind of has a sense of duty and a responsibility to him. so it makes him kind of quite a grey and kind of multi-layered character. He's also quite a good, like, kind of father figure character as well. And yeah, I think the stuff with the mythology as well, the mythology, like all the different like creatures and stuff that you usually see in, like, The Witcher with all the fantasy things, like the like giants and elves and different, like, goblins and stuff. Like, you don't really see that as much in Game of Thrones. It's more kind of based in reality, in the sense where humans have kind of taken over as much, quite a lot, and there aren't really that many mythical things around as much. There's more so rumors of mythical things, but with the White Walkers, you do see those in the first episode. So yeah, it's the White Walkers remind me a lot of zombies and stuff. So yeah, also Joffrey, well, I can't allow to say it, he's basically a complete knob. Joffrey is, he's like Draco Malfoy, if you, on steroids. Like, he's the most insufferable little shit, honestly. I was so glad when that, the wolf dog, bit him in that episode with, trying to defend, Arya. And yeah, really good show, highly recommend it. I mean, you've probably already heard about it already, but it is actually as good as people say it is. Also, if you like Avatar The Last Airbender, I think you'll like it. It's almost the most close thing I've seen to it, pretty much. Okay, I think that's all we have to say on pretty much everything. Thank you for watching. I know it's been quite a while. I just don't really like to make these videos when I feel like it, not really when I feel like I need to make a video. I want to make a video when I want to, and when I've got some stuff to talk about. So thank you for watching. If you enjoy the video, you can like it. If you enjoy my content, you can subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.